she was abandoned. From New Bombay, people came and dumped her outside the gate and went. She was in very, very bad condition, very bad. But she's perfectly all right now. Then, but she's a little dominating, so we don't use her for awareness. We use only Jalebi and we use Rani. Come here. Come. This is a very good dog. She was also abandoned. She was dying of a disease called distemper. And the other doctors had said to asked her to put her to sleep. That means to euthanize her. Okay. But our doctors decided we'll give it a try. After 3 months, she was perfectly all right. But she has a little chorea on her hind leg. That is, it has a nervous disorder. A little bit of shaking in there. But that is fine. That's okay. And she's very good with humans. And she's a very intelligent dog. So we take her for awareness. I have been in this field for the last 20 years, a working condition. And I was running another very local organization in Meera Bhayandar. This is when in 2000, Mrs. Manika Gandhi told me to start the SPCA as a, on a district level in Thane. So I handed over my other organization to the trustees, existing trustees there, and I started the Thane SPCA. This was in 2002. This is Mrs. Irani. She is a supervisor of the hospital. And basically, when we are not there, she is the one who runs the hospital. Nothing escapes her notice. Okay. She knows each and every animal. She can look at a cage and she can say that, okay, somebody has forgotten to give water or food or medication to this animal today morning. I would like to say it all comes from God, because we do not get any we do not take any government grants. Whatever is available also is so it's pittance. So we do not accept any government grants. Everything comes from individual donors.
हाँ वो नहीं का?
टीका क्या होता है? थोड़ा काली माता रक्षण करते हैं. ये मिथुन चक्रवर्ती.
ये डांस करते हैं बिचारे.
पूरा ऐसा एक्सीडेंट हुआ है ना कंट्रोल नहीं है.
We provide aid to both domestic and wild animals. Everything is medical aid, and after there, our motto is rescue, rehab and release. So once we rescue, whether it's a wild or a domestic animal, we rehabilitate them, we treat them. Once they're all ready for discharge, we rehabilitate them according to their needs. If it's wild animals, they are left in the wild if they are perfectly fit to be left in the wild with the permission of the forest department. If they are not fit to be left in the wild, they are taken to any kind of wildlife rehabilitation center which is recognized by the Central Zoo Authority of Government of India. The nearest one is in Pune. If they are domestic animals, if they are perfectly all right to be left back on the streets like street dogs and cats, we do that. This is the wild bird enclosure. All predator birds are kept here minus owls. Owls are kept separately. They have all come with injuries. Mostly wing injuries, and in the summer season they come with heat stroke, a lot of heat stroke. They just fall from the sky or from the trees, and public brings them or the wildlife department brings them, or when we go on our rescue missions we bring them. We keep them till they're perfectly all right. Many of them have had surgeries done on them, wings, basically wings, and when they're ready to fly they start flying inside and they come and towards the gate and get stuck with the wings outspread. Then we come to know that they are ready to fly. When we approach them, no, we really don't face much difficulties, because if stray dogs and cats are concerned, we have well-trained handlers to catch stray dogs and cats. We don't exactly face any difficulties while handling or approaching animals. The difficulties are faced because of space constraint. We have a small place. Any place would be small as compared to the needs of animals. So sometimes we are overloaded, and given the manpower that we have, it becomes difficult to manage the animals inside the hospital. Sometimes we have to say no to injured animals simply because we don't have enough space. sometimes we have to keep our animals outside the cages and kennels when we are overloaded. That leads to hygienic problems. These are basically the problems. Otherwise, handling or approaching animals is never a problem.
Yeah. Babu. बिना माँ के बेचारे तड़प रहे उनका तो माँ उनको माँ का जरूरत है और उस टाइम अभी बिल्डर लोगों ने वो जो जिधर खंडर में वो लोग बच्चे देते हैं ना तो वो सब निकाल दिया वो नीचे गिरे थे तो हम लोग जाके उठा के लाए कितना गलत बात है माँ को प्यार नहीं है माँ का कुछ नहीं माँ उधर तड़पती होगी बच्चे इधर तड़पते हैं तो हम लोग हाथ से फीडिंग करते हैं उसमें से देखते हैं भाभी ऊपर वाला
वी हैव अ टीम ऑफ सर्जन विथ अस दे हैव स्पेसिफिक टाइमिंग्स व्हेन दे कम इन दे डू द बेसिक ट्रीटमेंट एंड द सर्जिकल प्रोसीजर्स इफ देयर इज नेसेसरी in three shifts during the day every day our hospital is open 24/7 365 days so our people work here in shifts three shifts nine hourly shifts the junior doctors are known as livestock supervisors okay they are always there at any point of time to handle any animal emergencies and they work under the guidance of our team of surgeons I think they are bringing some animals
कोणतरी एक असं
Technically, the media students can help us by taking these campaigns out through the media, lobbying for our causes and putting pressure on government or on administrative authorities. But more than that, that is of course what media students can do. But personally, I'm very happy to see all of you. You all are so young and you all have taken up this topic, which is least thought about in social welfare issues. And I would request you all that whether you're in media or not, take this issue into your lives and change yourselves, change your outlook. Try to change one more person's outlook and I think you all will make a great society in future.
Memories crowding my mind, you're one of a kind, life without love. Raindrops and death, a strange kind of romance. I don't know why they cry out loud, but I'm feeling fine. Watch the rain.